Hello, you wonderful people, and welcome to another episode of Crime Centric. This being a show where I talk about crime dramas that I like. For today's episode, I'm going to talk about the latest episode of Banshee. So this episode began with a pretty interesting opening where we have, you know, Cruz taking a shower and everything. In my mind, I was thinking like, okay, either it's going to be Carrie or Hood there in front of her bathroom trying to, you know, get to her to get to Proctor. And it's like, nope, the person that's there is freaking Burton and he kills her. As it's like, wow, and then we go straight to the intro, I was like, wow, that was quick, because I thought that situation was going to be, I don't know, because it seemed like they were leading her up to something, because it's like, oh, you seeing her just kind of reminiscing about what just happened, you know, getting her ass kicked by Carrie, getting her face slashed up and everything, and it was like, nope, Burton quickly dealt with that. Multiple things went down this episode. We had the Brotherhood hitting Proctor. Basically stealing some of his shipment, you know, some of the drugs that basically he was going to give to the cartel. And even he talked to his, a senator later on about the whole situation. It's like, these are not the type of people we want to mess around with. They'll strangle us in our sleep with our tongues. Like I said before, I knew this situation, I mean, it hasn't gotten to there yet, but I feel like that's where it possibly will lead to. Is the fact of the matter is, they are dealing with cartels, and they are not the kind of people that like to be, you know, who like to wait around or who feel like they're being screwed over. So I saw that coming the moment, like, Calvin killed Watts. And it's just like, yeah, Proctor's business is going to be screwed, because now the cartels are going to rain hell down upon Banshee. But we did see Burton later on in the episode killing a lot of the guys that work alongside of Calvin, just because they were trying to track down where Calvin was, because which basically we only saw him one time this episode. Basically, you know, he's still looking for Maggie and kind of finally snapped. We saw before that he kind of was daydreaming about killing his boss. This time he actually did it, walked out shirt off, showing all his tattoos and everything, covered in blood, and just like all his co-workers are shocked. There was also that interesting thing between Carrie and her shrink, the one that kind of determines whether or not she gets her children back. And Carrie's just kind of like, there's no point, I don't deserve to be a mother. And he's trying to get her to open up. He's like, what's said here will not be in my records. And basically she's talking about the fact is that she's doing what she has to for Gordon, you know, talking about her taking down Proctor. And the reason why she's saying is because he was a good man, you know, he didn't kind of essentially didn't deserve that, and he had one goal, and that was, you know, taking down Proctor. And what really upsets her about the whole situation is because the entire time she was with Gordon, she was still in love with Hood. So that kind of made it even harder on her. But the shrink said something interesting. He was like, go do what you need to do. Go get the job done, and then come back and be the mother that your children need. Because he's saying, as a father himself, he understands. It's just like, wow, should a shrink be telling his patient to be going off doing something like that? But just like, okay. She did find out from that attorney, the district attorney, that his connect, that all this, you know, about his connection to the cartel. And it turns out, well, I mean, she hasn't done anything about it yet in this episode, but it does seem like it's going to eventually lead to her doing something. Exactly what? Who knows? Like, no telling exactly what she's going to do with that information. Also in this episode, we had Job confronting, I can't remember his name. He's the guy that took Job at the end of season 3. He's the one that everyone went to help them get Job back. He's the one, he took the money and ran. Job tracked him down, and basically Job was like, I've been thinking about what I do to you, like, when I got out, because he basically saying there's 20 months of my life that I'll never get back. But then he's like, I'm not going to kill you. Basically, he erased Home Dude's identity and replaced it with his own. Every crime he's ever done, every bit of money he's ever believed had been stolen, is now on this guy. Because anytime someone goes looking for Job, they won't find him, they'll find this guy. And he's like, come back here, Job. And Job just walks away. Because I was wondering, like, how Job was going to handle this situation, especially because Job was about to kill him. I was like, okay, go ahead and kill. I was like, I feel like, nah, you'd get your revenge some other way. He's like, I've seen the light. I was like, what did he mean by that? But very ingenious way of him dealing with that. I really like the fact is we got a really good look at Sugar and Job again. together again after so long. This is probably their first real interaction that, you know, since Job's been back. And basically he was like, Sugar was like, oh, this is just like old times. And then Job was like, yeah, you would know about being old, wouldn't you? He's like, and where's my computer at? It's right where you left it. Well, I'm not just gonna sit here, won't you go off and fetch it? It's just like that. Oh, I love it. Cause I even love the fact this bro, but he's like, hey, I know you. You're that guy. Basically, the shootout that happened at the end of season one. He's like, yeah, I remember you too. You were the cop that was who was lying down, screaming and crying about how you got shot. He's like, I remember I was there in a gunfight while you were laying down, screaming about how you got shot and everything. I was like, oh. But luckily, Hood did get Dawson's message, and they were able to track her down. Granted, they ended up getting knocked out and brought to the basement area, too, where, I mean, she was being held. Granted, Dawson handled that situation very well. Basically, she wasn't kind of giving into fear. She was kind of keeping up a strong front just so that he wouldn't get the satisfaction, kind of breaking him down psychologically. He's like, you can't, what was the term he used? You can't profile me. But she's like, I kind of already have that. Basically, you're a lunatic. You're insane. She's like, the devil doesn't exist, so... She even at one point, just to kind of keep him from doing what he's doing, basically is like, oh, let me join your group. And he's like, oh, you said that Satan doesn't exist. So it's like, guys, all kinds of crazy. And I was scared about that situation. I was like, oh, man, they're not going to get to her in time, especially because they're down there handcuffed and they can't get out. And then Brock is pushing Hood, he'd be like, okay, you got to tell me all these things. Who are you really? All these questions. He's like, tell me the truth. And then finally, he did what I didn't expect him to do. He told him the truth. He's like, I'm not Hood. I took his identity. I'm a criminal. I was in prison for 15 years. And that hit Brock hard because Brock was under the impression. Like, he's like, because he was never able to become the sheriff that he wanted to be. I mean, first he had to wait for the first sheriff to die, and then he kind of had to wait for Hood to kind of fall apart. And even when he became sheriff, he still couldn't be the sheriff he wanted to be because he had Proctor, you know, breathing down his nuts, kind of essentially. And then basically he had to, as well as, you know, just a multitude, just things weren't the way he wanted them to be. He thought things weren't the way he thought they would be. But it's just like, I can't believe he told him the truth, and just like Brock couldn't do anything but laugh about the situation. Luckily they were able to get free after they killed that doctor, dude. I figured that'd be the way out. And I was like, oh please, they're about to put a knife in Dawson. He's like, nope. Showed up, took everyone down, like Hood beat the crap out of him. He's like, you're so insignificant. And Hood's like, you're insignificant too, buddy. You're no different from me. And then like basically Dawson tells him to stop, and I was like, oh, is Dawson trying to have like actually arrest this guy? Dawson shifts the gun over and shoots him. I'm like, nope, she just wanted her own revenge. Because as we saw, like, she came back to everything later on when it was all said and done. It was like beating a stick over like the table just because it was just like, and lighting up just because it was just, it's a traumatic experience. Like, she was that close to dying. Wish we had Proctor come and show up and be like, okay, is this the guy who killed my killed Rebecca? And Hood said, yeah. He's like, thank you. And Hood didn't say anything to him, but it's like, to me in the back of my mind, I'm like, but I'm pretty sure he's probably still pissed at you about the whole Cruz thing. Cruz probably she probably did that on her own. It probably wasn't even Proctor's decision to go after her. Cruz probably did that on her own. Maybe that's why Burton killed her. I mean, it could also be because it's like, Proctor did send her, but like, she failed. I mean, granted, everyone else was already dead, so they didn't have to worry about those loose ends, but she was a loose end that they needed to tie up, so maybe that's what it was, or maybe it was because she acted on her own anyway, and needed to die for the regards of, you know, being a loose end. But it does make me wonder, like, how will Hood handle this whole situation? I mean, specifically Brock, now that Brock knows the truth, he hasn't really said anything since they took that guy down. I mean, one of the last shots we saw of the episode was over that Declan guy's body. Part of me is thinking, like, he's still alive, not just because of some supernatural force, but because, like, the implants he's got in his head, probably when Dawson shot him, it probably ended up hitting one of his implants so it didn't kill him. It probably knocked him out, but he's still alive. That's how I'm looking at it. Maybe he really is good as dead. But it's like, how is Brock going to handle it? I mean, he can't really get on Hood about it now because Hood's not the... he's not the sheriff anymore, so you can't really get on him for that. But it's also like... But it's also the fact is that he's like, oh, I killed for you. And Hood's like, no, you didn't kill for me. You killed for yourself. I just showed you the way. Because he's like, all the bad things that he kind of did while under Hood's guidance, in a sense. But it's like, not everything you did was bad. You did legitimately help out a lot of people. He even brought up Siobhan. He's like, did Siobhan know the truth? And he's like, nearing the end, yeah. But it's just like, I honestly don't know how he'll handle the situation now that he knows the truth. It's just, everything's coming to a head. I waited around to the previews just to see what it would say, and it did say the final episode. So do correct, because I looked it up just to make sure, because I was like, no way, it seems a little too soon to be like the final episode. Because typically every season of Banshee has been like 10 episodes. Next week's episode is the 8th episode, so not unless they cut down this season a little bit, you know. Because But from what it looks like next week is the series finale. Not unless, you know, there is much more to go on. That, you know, that there is more to, you know, this. That basically there are 10 episodes this season. Or maybe next week is the series finale. I don't know. Either case, I kind of hope it's not. Just so we can get some more episodes. But if it is, I guess I'm okay with that. I guess I wanted to it kind of to string out a little bit more, because I don't know. I get the feeling like, I don't know. I don't know. I'm stumbling. It's just because I don't want it to end. But if next week's the end, then let it be the end. But I know it's going to go out with a bang, because like I said, everything's coming to a head. Carrie's coming after Proctor. I'm sure Hood's coming after Proctor too, because it's like his daughter almost died, could have died because of what happened with Cruz and everything. So I don't know. And then also we have the whole, like, Calvin and Kurt thing. From what I can see from the previews, that's coming to a head, too. So I won't say anything specifically about what happened, just because in case no one saw. But it looks very interesting. And because of what was going down, it did make me think next week is the series finale. Like I said, if it is, oh, well, I hope it's not. But if it is, it's going to go out with a bang. I'm sad to see this show go, because I really like it. I did have the intentions of, like, rewatching the first, like, 3 seasons, but I kind of fell behind on that. I recently, a little bit before the season started, I'd only rewatched the first one. I still haven't rewatched the second or third one, but still. Nevertheless, probably at some point in time, I'll probably go back and rewatch them and rewatch this one just to kind of get the whole complete set. But still, it'd be quite interesting to see how everything ends, because I feel like this is that type of series that not necessarily everyone's going to have a happy ending, so. And like I said, I will add this note. There's still that part of my brain that's wondering, hoping it'd be kind of interesting if, like, this whole Declan ritual guy wasn't actually the one that killed Rebecca. That was someone else who just, you know, played the part, made it look like that was the case. But no, the way things are settled now, I feel like it definitely was him that killed her, so. But I guess the reason why I'm so hesitant to believe it, because we didn't see the full picture of her being killed. We saw bits and pieces, but I guess it was mainly so it wouldn't give away who her killer is. I mean, because the way they were setting it up, it made it seem like it was kind of a personal thing, that it was someone who knew Rebecca that killed her. So that's why I've been super reluctant to believe that it was just like some nut job Satanist who did it. But yeah. But that's really all I want to talk about in this episode. Till the next time we meet, be happy, be safe, live life to the fullest, and enjoy it. Good day and goodbye.